These latest headlines from ABC15 are sponsored by Lerner and Rowe Injury Attorneys. One call, that's all.
Hey, happy Sunday to you. I'm Amelia Fabiano with your top stories from ABC15 Arizona. A fire district along the border cutting through the border fence to rescue a Mexican man who fell from the top of the wall there. Check this picture out. It shows the members of the Aravaca Fire District cutting down the fence. This is in Pima County. Tangi Beckham is the Aravaca Fire District Chief, and she says since the man fell on the Mexican side of the border wall and Border Patrol wasn't able to help, that's when she made the call to cut that fence.
Several attempts were made to contact the Mexican authorities, and that's what we were waiting for, was for them to take action, and they decided not to take any action. In my 20 years as a firefighter, I've never had anything like that occur.
Chief Beckham says the man was taken to a Tucson hospital for treatment. She hopes better protocols for helping people who do fall on the Mexican side of the wall can come from this situation. Now to an update on a story we've been covering extensively for years. A judge upholding a permanent injunction that says the city of Phoenix is required to prevent this type of homeless camp from popping up again. You might remember the city was ordered to clean up the area known as the zone near downtown Phoenix, where thousands experiencing homelessness called the streets home. In 2022, neighboring businesses sued the city to have that encampment cleared out, and the court sided with those neighbors. The city met the court's deadline to have it all cleared out in November of last year, and city leaders tried appealing part of the ruling that required them to keep the area from becoming a public nuisance again, but lost. A statement from the city says they are committed to keeping it clean, and they'll continue working to find new solutions for homelessness. America Votes 2024. The Trump campaign is once again making a stop here in Arizona. Trump's VP pick, Senator J.D. Vance, will be holding an event at Generation Church in Mesa on Wednesday. It'll be the Trump-Vance ticket's third event in Arizona, of course, a key battleground state. Meanwhile, Vice President Harris and former President Trump will debate on September 10th. You can see that right here on ABC 15. Our team is busy putting together a panel of Arizona voters right now to offer real-time feedback during that debate. And if you want to take part, we posted what you need to know at abc15.com/election. Looking ahead to tomorrow, Congressman Greg Stanton and Senate candidate Ruben Gallego are expected to hold a roundtable discussion with Arizona union workers. On the agenda, their plans to protect outdoor workers from the extreme heat. You may remember back in March, we told you the Phoenix City Council unanimously passed an ordinance requiring all city contractors and subcontractors to provide heat safety plans. The roundtable discussion starts at 10:30 tomorrow morning. Count on us to let you know how it goes. Maybe you're looking for a new gig right now. Well, starting this month, USPS will be hosting a series of job fairs every Thursday. They'll be at different locations all around the valley. They are looking to fill immediate openings for letter carriers, automotive technicians, mail processing clerks, and more. That first event will be Thursday from 10:30 to 12:30 over at Burton Bar Library in downtown Phoenix. Hey, do you have an old bike sitting in your garage right now that you maybe don't need anymore? Well, our Second Chance Bike Drive could give it a new life, and your donation could make a big impact, providing bikes to adults and kids in the valley who don't have one. You can help out in several ways by donating a new or used bicycle at any Earnhardt dealerships or by donating money to help refurbish bikes. Just scan that QR code on your screen or at abc15.com/bike for all the details. All right, let's get a check of that most accurate forecast here as we continue about the holiday weekend. Maybe you're off tomorrow. You're trying to get some fun in today. Well, it's going to be hot out there, hotter than normal for this time of year. We're going to hit 108, it looks like, later this afternoon at Phoenix Sky Harbor. We're typically around 104 for this time of year. Highs across the state today will land in the low 80s in spots like Flagstaff, Window Rock, Heber, and Sholo, upper 80s in Payson and Prescott, 93 for Sedona's high, and 109 to 110 from Bullhead City down to Quartzsite. Overnight, we're dropping down mostly into the 50s and 60s in the high country and north of the rim. 40s, though, for Window Rock, Flagstaff, and the Grand Canyon. 80s overnight out west along the Colorado River here in Phoenix and in Gila Bend as we head into our Monday morning as well. From here, we're really heating things up. By Wednesday, we're going to be above 110 and holding that through at least next weekend. 114, it looks like, we'll peak at on our hottest day on Thursday. As always, for the latest headlines, weather, and traffic, head to abc15.com or download that free ABC 15 mobile app. Have a great Sunday.
These latest headlines from ABC 15 are sponsored by Lerner and Rowe Injury Attorneys. One call, that's all.